Can you talk about the movie further?
Like,
what's going on?
Same thing. The Joker movie came out, and I was at Comic-Con saying, hey, go to this movie. I was hoping to make $200 million, makes a billion.
Yeah.
Breaks a record for the most money ever by an R-rated
Yeah, I hope they
movie.
Get
not
that. It's like
not
serious.
A comic book movie.
You can take it seriously now, I think.
That's it.
Yeah.
So that movie woke them up to they can do dark, serious, R-rated comic book material.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So they're all looking for it. When they look at the charts, given that 95, 96 of the top 100 are owned by Marvel and DC, there's only a couple that are left, and there's only one that's dark.
Yeah.
And that's a thing called Spawn. And oh, by the way, Spawn 300 came out, which is the second highest selling book of all 2019.
Yeah.
Only Detective 1000 beat it. And then issue 301 of Spawn was number 11. It was the only title in the top 11 to be named twice. Was Spawn. So they're starting to see those charts. They're starting to see it. I had an Academy Award nominated creative person on the hook, and I had him, and I had the money behind him
because
they've been working with him. And they said, if you land him on the deck,
mm-hmm.
then we got the money. And we were this close, and he got off the hook last week because he just signed a big deal with another studio.
Yeah, I feel like they're taking too long with
and
you.
And he's like, oh,
you're
Todd,
setting things up, and then it's
driven.
The timelines in Hollywood are so.
Somebody gave me a great deal, and I need to be loyal to him. So I've got, on the way back from Toy Fair, I leave Monday, I go and meet another big Hollywood talent on Tuesday. We'll see where that one goes. But the phone calls are different now. They're asking. I'm not having to try to sell it. They're asking now.
Good. So well, I think they get it.
Yeah. Well, they're seeing $1 billion over on somebody's ledger.
Right.
And they're going, well, if we get a fraction of that, which one of these works? And they're going, well, the highest ranked one is Spawn.
Yeah.
It's available, right?
Mm-hmm.
So.
So your spin on it, is it more horror?
Yep.
Or like, what are the R elements of it? Like, is it more... do you want to do gore?
You go to R first off, because if you do good drama, there's drama movies without horror, without gore, without scares, that are just R-rated movies because they're just a drama, right? I mean, the movie Lion is R-rated because it's just adult fare, right? Because, so I want to combine that with then the elements of a little bit of spooky stuff,
mm-hmm.
so that every now and then when you're in the movie, you'll jump.
Okay.
I just go, what the hell was Todd? What the hell was that? Right?
Mm-hmm.
And I just want to present a superhero in a way that is different and dark and a little bit vicious.
Yeah.
That makes no apologies for doing what it does, because most superheroes are corporately owned and they can't sort of cross certain lines.
Right.
I'm not obliged to any of that.
Yeah.
So I think I can give a slight twist on that superhero presentation.
Yeah.
Of when you walk out of the theater, that you'll go, I don't know how he does it, and it's
mm-hmm.
freaky and crazy as all heck. Wouldn't ever want to go out with a drink with that guy because that was messed up. But I'm glad he's on our side.
Yeah.
I'm glad that the tiger is on our side, but like, don't even come close to that tail because shoot, he'll bite you.
So Spawn in this world, is it more? How can I put this?
He's more of a thing.
Yeah. Like, is it more? Okay, I know.
He's not a guy. Let me just tell you, he's not a man in a rubber suit.
Yeah. Is he more like Pinhead? Where like Pinhead walks up and his look is shocking at first, but then the things that he does are so shocking.
No, because
that
Pinhead, when I looked at him, still looked like a man in a costume.
Okay.
I could replicate that. I go, oh, there's a guy, and you put on that cool costume,
gotcha.
You put on the insane amount of nails in his head. And I like you'll never see two arms and two legs on my guy. You'll never see.
So it's more like an apparition.
You will never see the full body. I mean, you'll see arms and legs, but I'm never going to show you the complete look, because then it's like, it's just a dude in a costume, right?
Mm-hmm.
You're never gonna get all of it. So it's just gonna be pieces, and then when he gets big and dramatic, he's got a cape, so I can hide some of it. You're never gonna see it. What you should do, I'm hoping, if I do my job right, is that you should walk out of the movie and say, is that the human that turns into a ghost? Is that a ghost that turns into a human?
Yeah.
I don't know. Which one's the chicken and which one's the egg?
Right.
And I'm not going to explain how it works.
Right. So are you more focused about the world with Spawn in it or Spawn in the world? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, is Spawn...
A little bit of both.
Are we going to see Spawn a lot? Or, or is he just this force that arrives?
Yeah, and, he comes when he's needed.
Yeah.
So, like a good horror movie.
Yeah.
Right? You don't.
Keep him in the shadows, man.
You can't put a spotlight on him too much. He comes when, when he's needed, right?
Awesome. So, yeah. Very cool, man. Dude, it's great talking to you, as always. Thank you so much. Yeah.